In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the return to clock setting on the Apple Watch. What is this setting? Why would I want to change it? Well, when we're looking at our Apple Watch, let's go ahead and take a look at my Apple Watch here. When I'm looking at the Apple Watch and I go and open up an app, so let's just say I'm going to open up the calendar app here. So I'm going to tap on that complication. And when I do, what it does is it opens up the calendar. Now, when I'm looking at the calendar, so I'm looking at my Apple Watch here, if I were to tilt my wrist back, so I'm no longer looking at it, so I'm going to tilt my wrist back here, and you're going to see that it goes back over to the clock. That's what the return to clock setting is. How soon does it go back from an app to this clock when you tilt your wrist? Do you want it to be immediately, or do you want it to wait a couple of minutes? And why would you want to do that? That's what we're going to look at. Now, if you find this video helpful, what you may want to do is stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at return to clock. So as I mentioned, when we're looking at my Apple Watch here, when I tap on an app, so let's just go ahead and tap on the calendar app again. The return to clock is when or how soon that's going to change back to that clock face. So I'm looking at my calendar here, and then when I tilt my wrist back, you're going to see it goes back over to the clock, and it's immediate. What we can do is we can delay that. We can delay that for 2 minutes as an example. Now, why would you want to do that? Well, maybe you're looking at an app such as Activity. You tilt your wrist back, and then you go back over to it, and Activity is no longer there because it returned back over to the watch face. So what you want to do is you want to delay that for 2 minutes. Now what we can do is we can delay that for 2 minutes for every app, or we can actually set which apps we want to delay that return to clock for. So for most of my apps, I like to have it just return immediately. But when I am looking at the Activity, I like to have it return back over to the clock here within 2 minutes. I don't want it to be immediate. Now, we can do this from two different areas. We can do this from the Apple Watch itself, or we can do it from the iPhone. I find it a lot easier on the iPhone, but I'll just show you where it is on the Apple Watch, but I'm going to tell you it's a lot easier on the iPhone. All right, so let's go over to my Apple Watch to see where this setting is. First thing we need to do is go over to the Settings app. So I'm going to press in on the digital crown, and what that's going to do is give me all of the different apps. Now from here, what we need to do is go and find settings. So what you may need to do is just scroll up and down until you find your settings. When you tap on settings, what we need to do is go over to general here. This is under the general settings. So I tap on it. And now what you're going to see is a setting for return to clock. And when I tap on this, I can set if I want it to just immediately go back over to the clock when I tilt my wrist, that's what always is. Or I can have it set for 2 minutes after 2 minutes, and this is going to be global across all apps. Or what I can do is set it for after an hour. So this is going to be global settings. This is going to change it for all of the apps. But let's say you wanted to make it for an individual app. I want to have it on always immediately for everything, but maybe when I'm looking at my Activity or maybe the heart rate, I don't want it to go back over to the clock face right away. So how can we set it for individual apps? Well, again, on the Apple Watch, what we do is we just scroll up, and then you're going to see all of the apps. So with Activity, I tap on it, and now I can say custom, and I go after 2 minutes. So now every other app is going to go back to the clock face when I tilt my wrist immediately, but the Activity app will be for 2 minutes. So let's just go ahead and do that for heart rate as well. So I just swipe up until I find heart rate. And we're going to go with custom and 2 minutes. And that's all we have to do. So now when I'm on those two apps, what it'll do is it'll wait 2 minutes before it goes back to the clock face when I tilt my wrist. But if I'm in the Activity app or the heart rate, when I tilt my wrist, it will not go back to the clock face. It won't do that for 2 minutes. So that's how we do that from the Apple Watch itself. Now let's take a look at how we can do this from the Watch app on the iPhone. I find it a lot easier. So let's go over to my iPhone. So I'm looking at my iPhone here. First thing we need to do is we need to open up the watch app. This is all set up in the watch app. So I go to watch, and then we have to go over to general here, just like we did on the Apple Watch. And under general, again, you're going to see return to clock. So now all I have to do is just tap on that, and I can set it globally or what the default behavior is going to be for all of the apps. And then in addition to that, I can go and change it for individual apps. And you're going to see that it is set for custom on activity because I changed it on my Apple Watch. And when we go up to heart rate, what do you think we're going to see? Custom. So if I wanted to change this here, all I have to do is just tap on it, and then I can go and change it in here. I want to make it back to default. I just go over to default, and now it'll just go back over to the clock face, the watch face, right after I tilt my wrist. And it will do this for all of the apps, including the heart rate app, except for my activity app, because I still have that set for custom. So that is the back to clock setting on the Apple Watch. Basically, all we're doing is we're just setting how soon it's going to go back to our watch face when we tilt our wrist. And we can set up a default behavior, so all of the apps will follow that default behavior. And then what we can do is we can go and set it for individual apps. And we can do this from the Apple Watch or from the watch app on the iPhone. Again, I find it a lot easier on the iPhone. So that is the back to clock setting on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, as I mentioned, there are ways that you can help support my efforts here in creating these videos. With YouTube, what you can do is you can like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, and you can click on the red bell. When you click on the red bell, you'll receive notifications when I release a new video from YouTube. In addition to that, what you can also do is check out my site, danstutorials.com. On YouTube, I have about 400 videos, a little over 400, and I'm adding to those on a regular basis, but I've been working on my website a lot longer than I have been on YouTube. So I have over 2,100 videos on YouTube, all for your Apple devices. The way that you can help support my efforts is by becoming a member of my site. When you become a member of my site, you get all of the videos ad-free, so you're not going to see any ads. You also get access to my online classes and webinars. I host Q&As or ask me anythings on a regular basis. These are live sessions and you're able to join me and ask me anything. And in addition to all of that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office in my house. And when you become a member, just know that you're helping support my efforts, small business, in creating these videos. So that's how you can support my efforts. And that is what Return to Clock is on the Apple Watch.